What is how we can calculate the year-to-date sales revenue? What exactly the year-to-date sales revenue? What it means year-to-sales revenue? So year-to-date, it means like, so I want to calculate the sales revenue 1st of Jan 2013 to till today's date. That is year-to-date. Let's say if user selected the March 15th, 2012. So then what data should display? So the sales revenue should display the data from whatever user selected till that date, from Jan 1st to whatever user selected, that date should display. That is the year-to-date sales revenue. And what is the month-to-date sales revenue, MTD? What is MTD? Okay, so what exactly month to date? So month to date calculations is, let's say, so I want to display MTD sales revenue means, MTD sales means whatever the sales revenue is happen from 1st December 2013 to 20th December 2013, so that data should display. That is month to date sales revenue. So then what is the YTD sales revenue? So YTD sales revenue is 1st Jan 2013 to 20th December 2013. Okay, whatever the sales revenue has happened 1st Jan 2013 to 20th December 2013. So that is nothing but a YTD sales revenue. Okay, so in our database we don't have the current data. So what I am doing, so the requirement is, say user selected, let's say user selected a 15th March of 2005 is selected. So user selected 15th March of the 2005. That means, so what should be the YTD calculation? It should be the 1st Jan 2005 to 1st Jan 2005 to. So it should display the 15th March 2005. Okay, so the data should display. Okay, so this is what year, like in my calculation, that is what the year to date calculations. Okay, because year to date means current, till current date I want to display, but the requirement is like, so because we do not have the current data in our databases, so what I am doing, based on the user selection, so till that date I want to display the sales revenue. That is YTD sales revenue. Okay, and also similarly, if the MTD sales revenue is nothing but, so March 1st 2005 to 15th March 2005 data should display. 15 days data should calculate. So let's create a report. So what I am doing, I am using the one of the island resort marketing universe here, just taking the resort country. Resort country, and I am taking the sales revenue and also the invoice date. Sorry, this query. Then what will happen? Whatever the sales revenue is available, so all the data is going to display in our report, right? So basically what data is available from 2004 to, we have a data from 2004 to 2006 data is available. Last day is 2006. Okay. See what I am doing here, edit this query, and I am creating a prompt on the invoice date.
okay,
between, let's say I'm select, I'm just giving the 2004 data. We have data from 2004 to from Jan 1st. Click on OK. Okay, then end date I'm giving is a date. So based on the date he selected from that date to this date, so we'll get the red sales revenue. So if I select the 2004 November, whatever the sales revenue is available from Jan 1st to November 2004 data will be displayed. See, even if I select 2005, let's say I'm selecting the 2005, or else like if you select the 2006 from Jan 2004 to till today's whatever date I selected, that data will display. But so what is the YTD calculation? YTD means whatever user selected a year, so till that date here, Jan 1st to 2, so till that date data should display. But the sales revenue which is not displaying now, so all the data is displaying. So now what I am doing, I am going to write a calculation here. So first I want to know what date user selected, okay. So I need to compare that user selected date and with the invoice date, okay. So let's see now. So I am creating a new variable, P underscore, this is about a prompt, okay, let's say prompt date. Okay, how to display the prompt date? So we want to display the prompt values in our report. What function we have to use? User response function, right? Date, validate this. Click on OK. Okay, let's say. Look at my idea. So whatever the date is, see, I don't want to display the timestamp. So for that, I am writing a formula here, to date. I don't want to display the to date of validate this. Now the timestamp will not display. No, no timestamp, right? So as of now, this is the calculation it is displaying, which I selected November 2006, right? So this is which is displaying from 1st 2004 to till date it is displaying. But so I want to, if I select the 2006 means November 2006 means it should, the sales revenue should calculate from 1st Jan 2006 to November 24, 2006, that should display. That is what YTD. So as of now, this sales revenue is for the all the sales revenue from 2004 to till date. Okay, that is not YTD. So what I am trying to do? So based on the users selected, only till that date, that month, and that year data should display. Okay. So now what I am doing, whatever the year, month and week date is there, right, I am going to make it as a separate. So new variable, so year, okay. So then what I am doing, year you can take a year of the prompt, validate year, formula is correct, you can okay. Then what will happen, whatever I selected the date, that year value will display, right? So just for your understanding, I am adding this, I will remove it later when I am doing calculations. Month. So month number of a year, month number of a year. Let will say it should display the November month. Okay, fine. So I'm creating one more variable for date. Day number of the month, right? Day number of the month, which is the prompt date. Click on OK. Then it should be a 24th day, right? It's a day actually, not date. Okay? Just modify this. Now I am creating another variable for invoice date, I underscore year. I underscore year. Year of the invoice date. Validate this. Done. So if I take the underscore here, what will happen? Okay, the underscore here. Okay, 2004, 5, 6, that all the data is displaying. Okay. And let's say the underscore. Let's take the month number of the year. Month number of the year invoice date. No, we can't use the case statement here. There is no case statement in the report level. That you can do it, that you can use it in the inverse level if you want it. Inverse level we can make it. And day underscore day, d underscore day. Okay, done. So let's say all the data is this time 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So guys, now what I want to do, let's say example, I'm creating a variable sales revenue I want to display for 2005. 2005 sales revenue, how to display? Can anyone have any idea how to write a calculation? Sum of the sales revenue. Okay, then I want to display the 2005 sales revenue. I want to display the total sales revenue for 2005. So, where, you can write a where clause also. Where the year is equals to, so if you give 2005, then 2005 data will display, right? Validate this. What happened? Invalid data there because it has taken a number. Okay, see. Okay, done. So now if you take the sales revenue, so that sales revenue is going to display. This is only the 2005 sales revenue. So I want to see 2005 sales revenue. So let's say month is equal to 5th month, I want to display. I want to fifth in 2005 fifth month data I want to display. And how to do it? And okay, D underscore month is equals to 5. So then fifth month data is going to display now. See, that changes. Correct? Or else let's say I want to display the less than 5 months. What it means? Less than 5 months means what data should display? 2005, Jan 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. 4 months data will display. This is okay. Material calculations. Okay, sales revenue, where see if I selected a 2005 data, then so it should be a D year is equals to year, right? The prompt year. This is a prompt year. D year means invoice date, invoice year is equal to prompt year. And D month less than or equal to month and day. So D underscore day less than or equal to day underscore day is less than or equal to day. Will it going to calculate the year to date? I have selected a March 15th of 2005. March 2005, right? That means what happened? This is selected date, 15th March 2005. So that means whatever is selected, year is equal to 2005. Month is a March month, means is a third month. D underscore month less than or equal to 3. So Jan, Feb, March data will display. D underscore day less than or equal to day. That means day I have selected 15. So less than 15 data will display. That is what? So year to date calculations is calculating, right? Now add a report. So resort and country. Now take YT. So then I want to create another column which is the previous year to date. I'm just copying this. So where we need to write? So make it minus 1, not D underscore year minus 1. You need to make it as a year minus 1. So that means, so year is equal to, let's say I have selected 2005, then it is calculating the 2004 data, 2005 minus 1, 2004, right? So this is about the previous year to date. So you guys know how to create the variance, right? Okay. So then another calculation, month to date. How to do the month to date calculation? First, month to date means what it means. Say, let's say user selected a 15th of March. 15th of March means it should calculate, month to date should calculate 1st March 2005 to 15th March 2005 data should display. This is what the calculation, right? So with the existing formula. In this work, d underscore month is equal to month. See, if you give it less than or equal to, then so old, I mean less than or equal to 5. 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4 months data should display. Here month is equal to month. I selected the March month. So sales 7 is going to calculate the, so d underscore month is equal to current month, whatever I selected. That data should display. So till 2 days date, less than or equal to day I give. So d underscore year is equal to year and d underscore month equal to month. So that is means like, let's say select the November month. So only the November month data is going to calculate it. And till November, in the November, till what date? So the date I am selected here. Validate here, formula is correct, you can OK. Now you can say, take this month to date calculation and let's have a previous year to month to date, previous year month to date, what it means? So copy this. Previous year month to date. So this should be going to minus 1. Make it as a measure object. Validate here. Formula is correct. Now let's say add a report. Take the country. Take the country, resort, I'm taking a year to date, okay, previous year to date. So month to date, previous year month to date. This is how we need to calculate the data. Okay. Fine. Now let's refresh this report. Now let's say I'm selecting the 2005. Then 1st Jan 2005 to till date, whatever I selected, that date calculation will happen here. This is 2004. Let's say if I select the 2004, then there is no data for 2003. So previous year to date should display 0. No data. Let's say if I select a 2005, then So this data is going to display here 20200030. Let's say just I'm changing the year, that's it. What happened? See 200030, it is displaying the previous year to date.